Hello everyone, welcome back to Rice City class and this is video number 22. Hope you are fine and safe. Did you study the topics which we have discussed previously in the last class? I hope it is so. What are things we have discussed? We have done the activity of animating the sprite, or we can say that moving the sprite. The activity number 5.2, animate the sprite. There we have familiarized about different block palettes, and familiarized about motion, color, sensing. These are some of the tabs which are helpful for doing this activity. Okay, and in the keyboard we understood how to click on up arrow, down arrow, left arrow, right arrow. So when we click on these keys, what will happen, what change you can notice on the sprite? Means the character. Here, what is the character? Is the car. Okay, and also we studied how to give forever a flag. Means for starting the game. Okay, so these all things we have discussed in the last class. So after doing these all things, when we started the animation, that means when we started moving the car, this car is moving forward, and when the car gets out of the track, nothing is happening. So it must not be like that. If it is a game, when the car moves out of the track, the game must be ended, or else what we can say, the car must get hidden and car must be placed in the first position itself. That means if we are playing a game through in mobile and all, when we get out from the game, what will happen? The object will come to the first position. Okay, in the same way, when the car moves out of this track, when it touches the ground, the car must come to the first position. That means the game, we got out from the game and we have to start from the beginning. Okay, so here we will be doing that activity 5.3, when the car moves out of the track. Okay, two activities we will be discussing today, when the car moves out of the track and changing the costume. So with these two activities we will be finishing this chapter also. So for that, what we have to do, we have to open our file where we have saved that, in desktop school resource folder. In standard 8 there is a folder game. Here you can see our car game. So I'm opening this. This is the script which we have prepared, and by using the script you can see we have to click on the flag button, then only the car will start moving. Here I am clicking on the up arrow, you can see the car is moving. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to do the activity that when the car gets out of the track, what will happen? We have to bring the car to the first position. That means the game must be started from the beginning. Okay. So for that, we will be placing the car here. That we have to write the script. So what is the script we have to write? In the textbook it is given clearly, when car moves out of the track, we have to use, for doing this activity we have to use the techniques like color sensing, show, hide. These are the three separate techniques which we have to use for doing this activity. That means color sensing, you can see in this here you can see sensing. You can see the tab sensing. Under the motion, you can see a lot of different blocks. You can see under control, you can see different blocks. So here the first thing which we are doing is we are giving a if condition. We are giving a condition. That means if the car moves out of the track, what must be happening? The car must come to the beginning position. Okay, so for that we have to give the condition if. So I am placing the condition over here. Okay, after that what I am doing is if car moves out of the track. So instead of that, here the block is in this in separate way. That means you can see here, if the color, this is the block, this I am placing over here. If the color of the car, here the color of the car yellow, either we can choose yellow or you can choose the window color black. If this color touches the ground color is green. Okay, so in that way we can create the block. So here the color of the car, I will take the when we click here, we will be getting a color picker tool. Okay, so from here, from that I will be taking the color black. Okay, now you can see the color change to the black. Next, again I am clicking here, the color black color of the window color is the black. So any color we can choose, either you can choose yellow or you can choose the black color. So if it touches the ground color is green. So this I am selecting, so the green color appears. So if the color of the car, the black color of the car is touching the green color of the ground. Okay, green color of the ground, what must be happen? The car must come to the first position, the beginning position. Beginning position means we can create the block like X and Y direction. When my mouse is moving, you can see the value changes in X and Y. Okay, so when I place the mouse point here, what I am getting? Okay, that I have to write here. So if the color, black color of the car is touching the green color of the ground, you can there is another. There is another. We have to go to the option this block motion, and you can see go to X Y. This block I am keeping over here. Here, when we place the cursor here above the car, you can see the X is minus 5. Just a second. We can place the car over here. That means we can place it here in the black positions. Okay. What is the X is 6 and Y is minus 21. Okay, so I will be writing here X is 6, it is minus, again we will be getting minus 116. Okay. So what will happen if after the car moving, when the car goes out of the track, what will happen? This code will work. This code, what is this code? The car must move to this first X and Y direction. The X must be 6 and minus 116. When X value is 6 and minus 116 means the car must comes to this direction. How we got that? When we place the car here, when we place the mouse here, in this any of the position, how much we are getting? The X and the Y value, that value you have to write here. Okay, so the car will place here. So in any portion you can place, in the beginning position, in any of the position the space, we can place the cursor. Okay, so at that time you can notice the change X and Y value, and that you can write here. It may varies. Okay, it is based on how we are placing the cursor on the car. Okay, if you place here you can see the x and the y value changes. If you place here, the value will be changed. So it is according to your wish. It must be in the beginning position. So when I place here, what value I got, that I am writing here. Okay. So if the color, black color of the car touches the green color ground, what will happen? The car will come to the beginning position. How we got the beginning position? What value when we place the cursor here, that value we have written here. So that means this value will be getting when the car comes in the beginning position only. Okay. So after that, so this is the code. So before that, we are giving two more conditions. That means if the color black color, you can see in the textbook, if the black color touches to bring, here you can see go to XY to bring back the car to the starting point where the game started, for this we have to use this block. Okay. So after writing that condition, we have to write these three more steps. That means if the car black color is touching the green color ground, first what we have to do, the first condition we are giving, hide the car. Okay, so we have to hide the car. From where we will be getting the option hide? Looks. This is the new block which we are familiarizing. Under the looks option, like this block palette, we will be getting an option hide. Okay. Looks means it is about the car, about the object. For making visible the object, for making invisible, we will be going to the block palette looks. Under you can see an option hide. So here we can place it here. Okay, above this one. So first, if the black color of the car is touching the green color of the ground, first we have to hide the car. After that, we have to wait for 1 second. Okay, here we are giving another condition, wait for 1 second. Here I am reducing the 1 second to this hide must go. Yes, hide, and here I am reducing the time to 0.0009. Okay, first we have to hide the car, wait for this much second, and after that the car must be visible in the beginning position. Okay, and the car must be visible in the beginning position in 90 degree, in the straight to right direction. It must move forward to the right direction. The car must be in this way. The car must be placed straight. So further we have to write one more condition, and that is point in direction. Point in direction. It comes, it is a new another block. You can see here, point in direction, to set the direction of the car towards the right. So by default, when we give this method, this block, what will happen automatically when the car moves out of the track, the car will wait. First the car got hidden. After that it will wait for almost 1 second. After that the car will come. Where the car will come to the beginning position, and it will be in the correct direction to the right. Okay, so here we are giving, this condition is under the motion, point in direction, that we will be placing here, point in direction, it is of 90 degree right. Okay, so I hope it is clear to all of you. Okay, so here before starting the animation, we have to add one more code. That means if the color, black color window of the car is touching the green color road, not road, ground, what we have to do? The car must be hidden and wait for 1 second. After that, the hidden car must be showed. So for that we have to add block. It also comes under looks. You can see here looks. The car must be showed again. Then we have to go to the other instruction. Go to X. I have changed here the values 4 and minus 118. It will, so when I change the value, it will be more good to see. Okay, so I have changed x to 4, y to minus 118. So I have placed the x value and y value. So the car must be car will come to this point and it will be turned in right direction in 90 degree. Okay, so this is the code. Okay, so what we are going to start the game. Light the flag. Flag is light. Okay. I am moving the car. Car got hidden. What happened? The car goes out of the track. The car got hidden and again the car came here. Once more I will be showing. The car is moving out of the track. The car got hidden for 1 second. The car came here in the beginning position in the 90 degree to the right direction. Once more I will be showing. The car is moving backward. Car is what happened? Car goes when car goes outside. Again the car when moves out of the track, car got hidden and again the car starts in the first direction. Okay, so this is the code for doing this. Next we will be doing one more activity, and that activity is of changing the costumes. If we want to give two costumes to the car, okay, here only the car color is given as yellow. If I am going to give two costume to the car, that means for the running car I will be giving one costume, and for standing, that means if the car is not moving, I am giving another costume. If I want to give like that, that is also possible. That is the activity here in the here you can see in the textbook. Changing costumes. You have prepared the car game. Did you notice that running car and static car are of the same shape? If I want to make attractive the running car, we can make a slight changes. How? We have to select the sprite car. So here we are going to here I am going to select this car. After that you can see it on option here costume. Click here in the option and here and once more I will be adding. Okay, here I am going to add one copy. You can see here copy. So I am taking the copy of the already we have one car. I am taking the copy. You can see here car one, and there is an option edit. Okay, here I am going to make slight change on this car. I am going to click on ellipse and here I am choosing one color, and here I am going to draw shape. Okay, that means if the car is moving, you can see some shapes along with this car. Okay, then I am going to click on OK. So you can see when the car is moving, we can see the shape. So before doing that, we have to add some instruction in the script also. That means if I am going to add this instruction only to the up arrow for watching what will happen. So if up arrow key is pressed, that means if the car is moving forward, what will have to do? We have to add one instruction. That means we have to take the add one instruction, that means switch to car one. You can see here two cars are available. So if the car is moving, that means if the forward arrow key is pressed, the car will move. So what will happen? Two cars are available now. The car must be moved as car one. Okay, car one. Okay, so that costume, how that is a script, how we can write? Here
Here in the looks there is an option. Switch to car 1. So if the up arrow key is pressed, switch to car 1. Move 5 steps. Okay. After that, we are telling another option, wait. Wait here for some milliseconds. Okay. Again, back to normal. That means switch to car. Switch to the costume. Car. Here we will be changing to car. So what you could understand, that means if up arrow key is pressed, when the car moves, we have to see slight change, which we have made another costume and we have given name it as car 1. So if the sprite is move, if we click on the up arrow to the forward direction, you can see the car 1, the costume, the car with the costume, car 1 will move in the forward direction. After that it will wait, and again it will, when we stop the car, it will turns to the costume will change to car. Okay, this I will be showing this. I am moving this. You can see the car is moving along with the, you can see some 4-5 dots here. So here I am clicking on a side arrow. What happened? You can see the car 1 changes to car. Okay, there is no dots here. So this code we have applied only to the code only to the up arrow. That means if the car is moving, you can see the costume changing. If I am clicking on the left arrow and back arrow also, there is no change. Again I am clicking on the up arrow, you can see the costume change. I am clicking back arrow, there is no change in the costume. I am clicking on the left arrow, no change in the costume. Again I am clicking on the front arrow, the car moves out of the track. Again it came to the beginning position. Again I am moving, you can see the costume with the car 1. I am going to the back direction, there is no change because this I didn't apply this code to the other conditions. That means to the back, right and left. Okay, so I hope it is clear to all of you. With this much we have our chapter is completed. Okay, this is very interesting, right? If you have any doubt, you must ask me in the upcoming Google Meet. In the Google Meet, we will be discussing this table, table 5.4. Okay, so just go through the textbook. If you have any doubt, you must ask me, because this is full of coding. So you will be having the doubt. So you must ask me if you have any doubts. Okay. So all the things we have discussed related to this only, by using this itself we have done the two activity, and two more things we have studied, that is of looks tab and changing the costumes. So we familiarized about the looks tab, and inside under the looks we have familiarized about hide, show, these all things. Okay. So those who are having computer, practice the activity. See you in the next class. Thank you. Bye.